Just to conclude and then take questions, I just want to say to Ohioans out there, if you are an Ohioan who is currently insured with health insurance, don't think the health insurance debate doesn't affect you. The study we are releasing today would indicate that there are some radical proposals out there by Senator McCain and others that will cost $922,546 of you who currently have health insurance, your health insurance. So as you pay attention to a lot of what's going on over the course of this fall, remember, just because you have health insurance now, there are radical proposals out there that could cost you your insurance. With that, we can take questions.
Actually, this question is for Jim. Can you get up to the podium and explain how this would affect the average school boy or teacher, and their, I assume most of them have family coverage that's pretty good. How will this affect them, both with their coverage and financial?
And I should say to you, the reason we're going to continue the podium is for Joe's sake because of the microphone. So as she asks questions or questions come up, please go up to the mic.
Thanks.
I can't enlighten us to exact numbers in terms of dollar cost, because healthcare differs in terms of what it costs in the school districts across the state. But certainly, it doesn't make sense to us that there be any incentive for employers to continue to provide healthcare to school employees if they're going to have to pay payroll taxes on top of the healthcare itself. And certainly, it doesn't make sense to us that it's going to help school employees anyway if they're going to have to pay income tax on that amount of money that they don't have to pay at this point. So I think those are the major effects that it's going to have on both the employer and the employees.
Any idea, though, of how much, if a school employee lost the coverage and they had to go buy some more coverage on the open market, how much that would cost?
I've seen varying numbers. I think a single plan, it's probably somewhere between $7,000 and $10,000 a year, and a family plan somewhere between $12,000 and $50,000 a year. And really, I don't quote any of those numbers exactly, but I've seen those kinds of numbers.
Any other questions?
How do you come to that number of $922,546?
Karen, I'm not seeing for that.
Yeah. We worked with the Economic Policy Institute to develop estimates of how many people would be losing coverage nationwide, and then broke that down on a state-by-state basis. So it's related to what the total loss of coverage would be under the McCain plan, and then the proportion of Ohioans who have employer-provided coverage is then part of the formula.
Is this expected to come from like small businesses that don't feel they have to cover employees anymore because of tax credit? Or?
I think it comes from a range of employers. What you expect to see are both small businesses, and for that matter, medium or large sized businesses, who think that they don't need to provide coverage any longer because people have a tax credit to use. Also, part of the dynamic in the tax policy center, a nice analysis of this is that because for some folks who were young and healthy, they could actually use their tax credit to buy pretty decent coverage, might have high deductibles, but because they're young and healthy, they don't so much worry about that. So that the pool of people that employers are covering over time would become older and sicker, and so the premiums would go up and push the cost out of reach for employers who are still struggling to offer health coverage. You know, what we know is that premiums are already so high for employers, and to intensify that dynamic of cost for employer provided coverage to go up will accelerate the loss of coverage in the employer market, which we have already been seeing over time.
And the number is solely for people who lose their coverage because their employers don't cover them anymore.
That's right. As other people talked about, you know, there's obviously 46 million people with health insurance in the United States, and I think there's 1.3 million in Ohio who are uninsured. My understanding is that in Ohio, more than half of those people have income that's below 200% of poverty. So a health insurance tax credit that doesn't come close to the full cost of coverage doesn't really put health insurance within the grasp to begin with. So we don't expect to see a big take-up in health insurance among the uninsured.
Was there a formula used to come up with this?
There
EPA is also happy to talk to you. They have elasticity formula they use. They sell the commerce function and happy to talk to you for the fall or reports in their 12.
Under the Obama plan, is there I've seen a recent one with Obama saying that there's some kind of feature where businesses that don't provide health care coverage would have to pay in some kind of pool or something? Is that right?
The Obama plan has a feature that requires employers to either provide coverage that meets a certain standard or else to pay a portion of payroll into the pool that would provide subsidies to individuals to get coverage. I don't believe that it specifies what rate that would be. But that is, for example, was a feature of the plan that Governor Schwarzenegger was trying to get through in California. And similarly, in Massachusetts, employers who don't offer coverage are paying a portion towards the subsidies for everybody.
So does that have more of a, the Obama plan, does it have more incentive for businesses to pay health insurance than the McCain plan?
I think what it does is it builds on the employer's role in the health system that we have today. It has a requirement that employers are part of the solution, as you say. They are either paying on a payroll basis or providing coverage themselves. What it also does is it keeps in place the incentives that employers have today to provide coverage. So workers would not have their health coverage taxed, nor would the tax treatment on the employer's side change.
But under McCain's plan, employers would not be required to pay into such a pool or anything.
That's right.
Are there any other questions? If not, thank you for starting.